What about Murphy's face? Contrary to popular belief, it is not his own head, but only his skin that we now see on RoboCop.
Touch me.
Rob Bottin and Paul Verhoeven and Ed Neumar had all come up with the concept that there would be such a potential for psychological disruption, even if you would supposedly wipe someone's memories and emotions, they still might have some kind of residual humanity, where if they looked at themselves as a complete robot with no relation to their past organic form, they'd completely freak out and have a psychotic breakdown. So the idea was that surgeons had literally skinned off Alex Murphy's face and then placed it on the cyborg. So it's not like they transplanted his head, they just took his face off and laid it on the cyborg, and that was to give him his own little sense of identity.
It's cold.
They made this to honor him.
No.
Your husband is dead. I don't know you.
While that was the idea for the original movie, parts of both scripts for the sequels suggest that somewhere down the line, Robo had his skin replaced. In RoboCop 2, Murphy was to have parts of his face lost at the hands of Kane, revealing a metallic surface underneath.
Why'd you stop? You got it cracked.
I'm tired.
In RoboCop 3, Robo gets badly burned by the splatterpunks.
Jesus, Murphy, are you okay?
I'm fine, Anne. Thank you for asking.
Originally, he was meant to receive extensive facial reconstruction, a plot device that would conveniently explain why RoboCop no longer resembles Peter Weller. And while this was never shown in the actual movies, it is interesting. How long would Murphy be able to keep his real skin without having it damaged? It's reasonable to assume that after the first RoboCop film, Murphy gradually received artificial skin replacement. Related to this is another popular misconception, that shooting RoboCop's mouth would be the ideal way to kill him.
Shoot him in the mouth, splatterbrain!
Cyborg eats bullets, Jack!
Obviously, Murphy's metal skull makes this a useless tactic, whether his enemy be a splatterpunk or a Terminator.
You are under arrest.